understanding the culture. It's not the same if you are visiting Cali or Medellin or Cartagena.
It has different experiences, different type of people.
If you come to Cali, you need to be able to be with more happy people. We are too open. We love to go to the party. And if you're going to another cities, maybe you can try different kind of experiences.
Right. Yo, what's up guys, your boy Kels, and we are here in Cali, Colombia with
Daniela.
So we are here in Cali, Colombia, guys, and we are ready to teach you 10 things that you need to know before coming to Cali, Colombia.
Lo más importante que debes saber antes de venir a nuestro bello país.
Pretty much was a very important thing you need to know. So if you guys are ready, let's do it. Okay, and at number 10, guys, obviously you need to know some of the language. It's very important to know Spanish. Even if you know some conversational phrases, it'll help you get from point A to point B. It's always a pleasure when people come to a different country and know the language.
It's so important if you know at least some basic words to communicate with the people, because usually people here don't speak English. So it's important if you are able to speak a little bit of Spanish.
Exacto. So what are some words you think people should know, like conversation?
Some words, you know, like buenas tardes, buenos días, buenas noches, por favor, gracias, ayúdame con esta dirección, help me with this location.
Yeah, the directions.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so like she said, those are all basic things you guys should know. If you've ever taken Spanish in your life or you ever listened to a Bad Bunny song, you should probably know, you know, one or two words for sure. So brush up on your Spanish, make sure you're conversational before you get here. It goes a long way. Ya tú sabes, ¿verdad?
Sí.
You already know.
Okay, number 9 is understanding the culture. It's not the same if you are visiting Cali or Medellin or Cartagena or another cities.
Yes, very different. So if you guys ever been to Colombia before, I'm sure you know that Cartagena and Medellin and Bogota has different experiences, different type of people, even sometimes different languages, different words. You know, it's all Spanish, but it is different. So like she said, you should understand the culture of where you're going. Okay, Cali is much more, what would you say Cali is like?
I think Cali, if you come to Cali, you need to be able to be with more happy people. We are too open. We love to go to the party. You can dance salsa here. And if you're going to another cities, maybe you can try different kind of experiences.
Right, absolutely. So you have to understand the culture before you come somewhere because it is different. It's like going, you know, to Manhattan and going to the Bronx. Two different places, but it's all in New York City for sure. So learn and understand the culture and you'll be good when you come here. And number 8, guys, it's knowing where to stay, because every neighborhood in Cali is completely different. You have to understand the neighborhoods of where you're staying.
You know, we have places that you cannot walk and feel free to be like relaxed and exploring.
Right.
We have some places that is more dangerous and you have to be careful with your stuff. So if you know where to stay, if you know where to go, it will be, you're going to have a better experience.
I mean, obviously guys, if you're staying somewhere and you can walk somewhere in 5-10 minutes, have restaurants, have bars, have clubs, and people around there, you know, showing you the vibes, it's gonna be a different experience than just, you know, being somewhere else. You might have a nice place, but you have to travel 15, 20 minutes to get to all the action. So
that's important. If you don't have maybe friends in the city, you can find some touristic guides or someone that can help you with that, can help you with that kind of information, where to stay and where to go.
Right, very important, guys. So know where you're staying in Cali, Colombia, because it'll make a world of a difference. Here, guys, we are in the neighborhood of Granada, which is a very nice neighborhood.
Yeah. It's nice. It's a nice place to stay. It's one of the best with San Antonio.
Right. So, and both are maybe like 10 minutes apart from each other.
It's close.
Yeah, Granada and San Antonio. So, those are two great places you can stay here. Check that out. Know where to stay, guys.
Okay, number 7 is don't walk in the street after sunset. It's very important to be careful, and if you wanna go out at night, just ask an Uber, ask a taxi, just don't walk around.
Right, just don't walk around in the middle of the night thinking you know where you're going. Don't try to reenact the Michael Jackson video, The Way You Make Me Feel, where you're walking down the street trying to holler at girls. It's not gonna work for you though. I'm telling you right now. I've seen some different things here at night. I haven't been here too long, but I've seen enough that a lot of the streets look a little bare, they're a little dark, you know what I mean? So you will be walking by yourself.
Even if you are staying in Granada, San Antonio, it's safe, but you have to be careful at night. Just stay in your car.
Right, just stay in your car. And you said a lot of people don't walk, right, at night time?
Exactly, at night time, almost nobody's working.
Right. Make sure you guys are on point. Catch an Uber, catch a taxi. What's the names of the cabs?
We have InDriver, we have Waikali, we have a lot.
And at number six, you have to make sure you bring sunscreen. At least that's what she told me.
Yeah, it's so important because here the weather is always so warm. And when you are going out during the day, that can be dangerous for your skin. So it's better to protect yourself.
Yeah, definitely have to protect yourself because the sun is kicking out here, guys. Like, it's nice, the clear skies.
Hace mucho calor, mucho.
Mucho calor. I mean, there is a nice breeze, so you will feel better as you're going along the day. But throughout the day, guys, the sun is outside, it's afuera. And it's not going inside anytime soon.
Also, if you like to wear some accessories like, what is the name of that?
A hat?
Yeah, like a hat. Uh-huh. You can use also that kind of things to protect
yourself. For sure. Yeah, so use different type of protection. You can wear a hat, you can wear a visor, you know, wear some sunglasses. Definitely wear some sunscreen, guys, because you do not want to wake up feeling burnt the next morning. Right. All right, guys, and at number five.
You have to get a friend from Cali. It's so important because if not, they are going to give you gringo prices for everything. You are going to pay the double,
yes. Yes, or more. For sure, I mean, you guys have probably traveled before, and I'm sure that you know the deal when it comes to negotiating, or just knowing the prices will be different for locals, different for people that are gringos, right? And gringos are people just coming from another country that are here, you know, looking to explore or have a good vacation. So like she said, it's important to have a friend or just have someone that knows, you know, where to go.
What'd
you say?
Get a guide from here.
Yeah. Get a guide. If you end up overpaying for something, you know, it's gonna make you feel crazy at the end. You're like, man, they got me.
Yeah. We spoke about the language before. That's why too, if you are speaking in Spanish, also will be easier to get the right prices.
Exactly. Here. Get a friend from Cali so they're not charging you gringo prices.
Yeah. Number four, knowing the currency. It's so important to be clear about how different can be paying something here and paying that in your country.
Right, 100%. You guys have to understand the currency when you're traveling because if you don't, you'll never know how much things really are. You might think you get a good price on something, but you really might not be getting a good price. You know, and just knowing something that's simple, what I like to do is I like to know how much $5 is, how much $10 is, that way you can just add it as you go along. And everything here, guys, the currency is Colombian pesos, right? So I'd say like every cinco mil peso, $5, is like $1.
Right. So, but this is changing. Sometimes can be a little bit more, sometimes can be a little bit less, but it's like that.
Right, exactly. So just know that, you know, how much 5 is, how much 10, how much 20 mil pesos is. 20 mil pesos is like, you just divide it by like 4, so it's like $5. Mm-hmm. Right, so you'll get a good understanding of how much things are if you're able to just divide. But you're paying for a cab, you probably shouldn't be paying more than like $5, $6, $7, depending on where you're going.
That depends where you're going.
Right.
If it's far, if it's close, but you have to. That's also is important to have someone that can tell you if it's right or not.
Right, exactly. And the more time you spend here, the more time you understand by going to different places and seeing different things.
If you go out at night, can be a little bit more also the price of the transport. If you go during the day, it's less.
Right. Very important, guys, to know the currency, and that's number four. Okay, guys, and at number three, you have to carry the cash with you, man. It is so important. I mean, even in my experience, I went out and I went to El Centro, and I wanted to get some shirts, and I got a couple shirts, and that was cool. But there was another store right across the street, and I went to get more shirts, and then I went there, and they do not take card. And I was upset because I could not get the shirts I wanted. So it's important to carry cash.
Here you have some places where you can just pay with your card. But if you go to El Centro, or if you want to buy something in the street, you can just find places that they don't accept card. So you need to have Colombian pesos.
Si.
You have to, it's better if you just come with dollars and just change to Colombian pesos and you have the cash with you.
Right.
So you don't have that kind of problems, you just can pay.
Right, guys, you need to learn from my mistakes. And just because I'm here making a video doesn't mean that I don't make mistakes, but you have to understand, when you make a mistake, you have to learn from it and then grow. So carry cash with you guys, no matter where you're going, it's always better. You know, you should not be changing money in the airport. I change money in the airport, but I only change like $40. Mm-hmm.
Maybe a little bit, because you can use for your transport airport to your hotel or
right.
to your Airbnb. But if you are here, you can just change more.
Exactly, and that's exactly what I did. I exchanged 40 bucks because I knew that, you know what, it's not the best rate you're gonna get in the city. So just exchange some money to get to where you're going and then find another place where the local exchange rate is gonna be more in your favor.
Number two is enjoying the Colombian food. We have a lot of different kind of food to try here. So don't go to McDonald's, don't go to KFC. Just try Colombian food and I'm sure you're going to love it.
Yes, there's so much Colombian food to eat here and it all smells amazing when you're walking down the streets, from the arepas to the chicharron to the empanadas,
cholado,
the chantaduro. You know, all these things are popular here in Colombia and some are only native to here, like the chantaduro, ¿verdad?
Mm-hmm.
There's so much food to eat here, guys. And whether you get off the street or you get it in a restaurant, there's a lot of different places you can.
Different places, yeah, that depends what you want to eat. If you want something fast, you can just find it in the center, in the streets, people selling there, or you can go to the restaurants and you can find it there too.
Don't be afraid, guys, to eat on the street. I know sometimes you go somewhere and you're like, you're kind of iffy about eating on the street, you don't know how well it's prepared, but bro, yo, I had some chicharron in El Centro. Bro, it was popping. Well, there were three different types of chicharron that he gave us, and he gave us arepas también. So we had three different types of meat, and we had arepas, and it was a big bag, and it was like $5, right?
It was a lot.
It was a lot, very simple. And we had jugo de caña, which is like sugar cane.
Sweet and citric in the same time.
Yeah, for sure. So it wasn't as sweet as a regular lemonade, but it was really nice. It comes out like a green, kind of looks like more like limon.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Si.
But it was really good, guys. You guys have to come through and enjoy the Colombian cuisine. And there's so many different
don't
restaurants.
Don't forget the chantaduro, please.
Right.
The best one.
Right, that's our favorite.
Okay, guys. And number one
is definitely knowing what type of trip you want to have here in Cali, man. There's so many things to do and to see. They have the salsa, they have the clubs, they have the landmarks, the attractions.
You have to be sure what kind of experience you want to have in the city, because it's different the kind of activities you can do during the day, the kind of activities you can do during the night. If you like more like go to dancing, you can focus in that, or you can focus and going to the river, going to explore, walking around the city. Depends what do you like to do.
You guys are all different. Some people like to go to the club, some people like to go out to eat, some people like to be in the street, some people like to be chilling, like on a vibe in a resort, doing whatever you want to do. But there's so many things to do here in Cali. It's unbelievable, man. Like I said, knowing where you are in Colombia and knowing what's available is very important. Right, so we want you guys to have a great experience when you come to Cali, Colombia. That's why we made this list. All these things will help you have a better trip here, not only in Cali, but also in Colombia. You know, so we appreciate you guys for coming through. You know, Daniela, thank you so much for joining me.
You're welcome.
If you guys think of anything that we forgot on the list, definitely drop in the comments, let us know, so the people can know out there when they read the comments, stuff like that. That's it for us, guys. We're about to go out and have some margaritas.
Margaritas, cholado, yeah. Cocteles.
Right. Maybe a little salsa, something like that, man.
You have to dance salsa when you come, especially if you are in Cali. This is the salsa city.
Mm-hmm. We appreciate you guys for coming on a journey with us here in Cali, Colombia. And these were 10 things you need to know before coming to Cali. And we see you guys soon. So stay safe, stay blessed, stay dangerous. It's your boy Kels.
Daniela.
Y ya tú sabes.